To become a reader of English, a child must first learn to isolate the sounds within words, or phonemes. Researcher Kevin Lenzo appreciates this feat more than most people. At Carnegie Mellon University, he designs speech recognition software, which takes as input a recording of spoken language and then outputs the corresponding sequence of phonemes. Lenzo works with a representation of speech called a spectrogram. Time moves from left to right. High-pitched sounds are above low-pitched sounds.
Here we have two different people saying the word cupboard.
Cupboard.
And the second.
Cupboard.
Now you can hear they're different. The way they delivered it, their pitch, their timing is a little bit different. But also if you see cupboard, and we can see the here.
Cupboard.
And that's right below here. You can see some energy concentration here. And here is the other rendition.
Cupboard.
And you can see it here. It's almost completely washed out in comparison. Here we have another example, the word bear. Here we hear a strong southern accent.
Bear.
And here much less so.
Bear.
And you can see, if you look at the spectrogram, there's a lot more tilt going on here. A lot of energy in the high scooping down into the low.
Bear.
And down here, it's pretty much low and steady and even, and there isn't a lot of the diphthongization that's going on in the southern dialect.
Bear.
Lenzo also has to reckon with the fact that when people speak, their phonemes don't come out crisply, one at a time, but instead overlap each other.
It's not entirely easy to see where one phoneme begins and another one ends. For instance, Old Mother Hubbard. We have huh here in Hubbard, and you can't see very clearly where the H ends and the ah begins.
Isolating the sounds of speech is difficult even for Kevin Lenzo and high-powered computers. No wonder children sometimes struggle as they try to develop phonemic awareness.